In this video, I'm gonna show you how to make your very first video using Adobe Premiere Pro by taking very easy and basic steps. So let's get started. Hey guys, my name is Nima and welcome to my YouTube channel Nemo TV. If you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on your bell notifications. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Adobe Premiere Pro and start editing your very first video, including how to create a project, how to create a sequence, how to import your videos, how to add music, how to trim your videos, and also how to add the text, and as the final step, how to export it in an optimized way. So let's don't kill time and get started and open our Adobe Premiere Pro. All right, when you open the software, it's gonna show this pop-up to you to select one of your recent projects or just create a new one. So what I'm gonna do right now, I'm just gonna click on new project and then it's just gonna ask me to select a location for where I want my project to be saved at, and then I just select the name for my project, let's say Project 001. You don't need to change any of these settings usually in most of the times, and so I'm not going to do that right now because it's set. And then I click on OK. Perfect. Now, the next step would be creating a sequence. You might ask, what is a sequence? Why would I need to create a sequence? The short answer to that is sequence is used in order to maintain a consistent setting, including the aspect ratio, the resolution, I mean the frame size, the frame speed of your video, especially when you use different cameras with different settings. So this is to ensure that you're consistent throughout your video. In order to create a sequence, you have two options. Make sure that you're on assembly tab over here from the top menu, and over here make sure that you're on your project, because if you click on this icon over here, you can switch between different tabs. Make sure that you're on project over here. On this void, you just right click and you select new item and you click on sequence. Or the other option would be go to file, new, and select sequence. Depending on what your camera is, you might be recording your videos on 4K or 1080p, which is full HD. The footages that I'm gonna edit today have been recorded using a DJI Mavic Pro Zoom drone, which has been done by my friend Marco. Hey Marco. So over here, I'm just gonna select a predefined preset for 4K video. You can do the same. So from the presets, I go to Red R3D. And you can see 1080, you can see HD 4K. So if you have 4K, I usually go to HD 4K. You have to know your frame speed. If you don't, that's fine, just put it on 24 or 23.976. But if you want to have your sequence, your video, your output to be on full HD, even if you recorded it on 4K, you can select the 1080p over here. So the first one is the resolution, the frame size. The next one is the aspect ratio. And the third one over here is the frame speed. We are not gonna dive into the frame speed if you don't know about it, but don't worry, you're gonna cover it in upcoming videos. However, for the sake of this video, we are just gonna stick to 29.97 from the 4K one right here. So I just select it. And all I need to do is just click on OK. If you want to make changes to your sequence or the settings of your video, after you select this, you can actually customize it by clicking on setting. Over here, you can just change your frame speed. You can change your frame size to whatever you want. And just click on OK. And all right, I have my sequence and I can see my timeline over here. The next step would be importing the video footages from the drone that I'm gonna put them all together and create my video. In order to do that, from the same tab, assembly project, over here, you just right click, you go to import, or you just drag and drop it. You just bring the window over here and drag and drop it into this empty spot, and you're gonna be able to see that. So I'm gonna just import it from here. Right click, import, and I have all of my drone footages over here. So all I do is I just select them all and click on open. So what it's gonna do is just gonna import all of them in here. They're gonna be processed and ready to be used on my timeline. I want my video to start with the intro. This video is like 1 minute and 50 seconds. I want to watch it and just select, let's say, 15 seconds of it and use it on my video. In order to do that, I double click on that. I'm going to be able to see it over here. And you see this blue pin over here? I can just drag it and put it wherever I want, and then I press the play and I'm going to go through this single video. And I'm going to be able to just go to where I want my video to start from this video. Okay, let's say from here. If I want to grab it from here, after I put the pin in here, I just click on this, mark in, and then I'm just gonna play it. Let's wait for the drone to get away. Okay, here is fine. And then I click on mark out. You see, I've just selected this out of this video. Now all I need to do is just drag this and drop it on my timeline. In here it says that the sequence setting is not aligned with the video. That's because of the frame speed. So the video was recorded on different frame speed, but I want it to be maintained and consistent with my sequence. So I click on keep existing setting. Perfect. You see this, the video is over here. You see this horizontal scroll ball? If you just drag it from the endpoint and change it, you can actually zoom in on your timeline. So this is better. Now, if I just click on any of the times over here, I'm gonna be able to see the final video. So right now it's perfect. And it's gonna end right here. Now it's time for the next one. I wanna put Skyline 1. Let's say 10 seconds of this video. I double click on this. I'm gonna be able to see the video over here. I just take this to where I want the video to be started. Let's say in here. Mark it. Let it play. Stop. Mark out. Now I drag and drop it after this. Perfect. If you have a space between your elements, all you need to do is to just drag and stick it to the next one, to previous one, or click on the empty spot and then hit delete on the keyboard. Bonus tip, if the element is not sticking like this, there is a chance that your snapping timeline setting is off, so make sure this is on. Okay, I just drag it here. The next one, let's put street view. I double click on this. I'm gonna be able to play through the video. Let's start it from here. Let it be playing for like a couple of seconds. Cars are moving. Stop and mark out. And then I just drag and drop it here. And as our final scene, I'm gonna have the yachts to show up. Like this. Start here, let it play for, let's say, a couple of seconds, and then mark out, drag and drop it here. Alright, right now I have all of my footages aligned one after each other. As the next step, I want to add some music to my video. I want it to sound cooler. You see this double line over here? Whatever you have on top of this are visual based, are the videos, pictures, text that you're gonna add to your videos, and whatever you see below this are the audios, what you can hear, the audio of your recorded video, the audio which can be the music that you add, your recorded voice, whatever is gonna be below this double line. Okay, I've already selected the music. In order to import the music, it's the same way that as you import the videos. I right click over here, make sure that you're on assembly, project, right click over here, import, and I have my music over here. Perfect. The same way that we selected the time frame of our videos, I double click on the music, I'm gonna be able to play it. Alright, let me select Martin from here. Let's play. Perfect. And let it be playing for a while. mark out, drag and drop it, but this time you won't be able to drag it here. It's gonna be on this section. And then I just drag it from the end and I just drop it where my video ends. And if I click on any of the time frames over here, I'm gonna be able to go back to my final project. And if I hit play, I'm gonna be able to see that. Alright, as we are getting closer to our final steps, let's say we want to add the text during our video. Super easy. All you need to do is to just click on this type tool, and after you click on that, you go to where you want your text to start showing up. Let's say I want it to start at after the first second. After I select my type tool, I just get in here, I click on the video. This is gonna show up. I just type in whatever I want. My first video. Okay, I wanna make it bigger. In order to do that, first you need to click on selection tool, so it's kind of confirmed. Just make sure that your text element has been selected. And then you go from here. From assembly, you go to editing. Then make sure you are on effect controls, and over here you see the text. You open it and you see you're going to be able to change your font, the style, whatever is related to your font. I make it bigger. Okay, this is fine. And in order to move it, you can, if you scroll up, you see the position, you can change it accurately however you want by changing its X and Y coordinates. Or an easier way, since you've selected the selection tool, you just select your element from here and just put it wherever you want. And over here, you see, it's gonna start from here and end in here. Let's see if it's long or short. My first video, nice. And then it's gonna just end. All right, I wanna make it shorter. I just drag it here. And my video is ready to go. So the final step would be exporting your video. First of all, make sure that you've already saved your video, because you won't be able to export it if you haven't saved it. In order to export your video, all you need to do is to just hold the control button and then just press M, or from the menu, you go to File, the way that I do it, Export and Media. And in here, this window is gonna show up. We wanna make sure that we are having the highest quality while having the least file size. That's why in here, from the format section, you need to make sure you choose H.264. This is the way that I do it. And on your preset, you have match source, so it's not gonna downgrade the quality of your video. And then the final step would be choosing the name and the location where you want your video to be saved. So you click on this blue text and you select the folder, and then let's say my first video, and then you click on save. Here you can see the final file size, which is 31 megabytes, and then you just click on export and you get ready for your video. Congratulations, you just made your first video using Adobe Premiere Pro. Nice, I'm getting emotional. So this was the first of many tutorial videos that I'm gonna post on this YouTube channel. So if you like this video, make sure that you hit that subscription button and turn on your bell notifications. I'm making happy. In the upcoming videos, I'm gonna cover lots of other cool features of this Adobe Premiere Pro. I hope you like this video. Below in the comment section, let me know if you have any questions related to this video, any suggestions for the upcoming tutorials, and let me know what you think. And if you like that, make sure that you hit that like button as well. Thanks for watching. Take care.